So in this session, we are going to talk about Control-M databases. So whenever you install Control-M Enterprise Manager or Control-M Server, in that case, both of these components require a database. Okay, so Control-M EM doesn't store any of its data on the folders and files structure. It stores everything in a database. Now, by default, Control-M comes up with PostgreSQL embedded database. So what it means is you don't really need to install external database. You can just go ahead with using Control-M embedded PostgreSQL. Okay, and that is going to work very fine because I have seen that even in a when you have jobs of up to 50,000, Control-M embedded PostgreSQL is going to work just fine. It is not going to give you any issues. However, let's say for some reason your organization wants to change the database, so that can be done as well. Okay, and it stands true for both the components, Control-M EM and Control-M Server as well. So by default, when you install Control-M EM and Control-M Server, there is a default database name which gets created with EM900 for Control-M Enterprise Manager, and this is for version 9. So in version 8, the database name is EM800, and similarly for Control-M Server, in version 9, the default name is CTM900. So let's say if you want to connect to these database using some sort of, you know, database client utility, you can connect to these databases as well. So this is going to be the database name and database username and password you are going to provide when you are installing a Control-M EM or Control-M Server. Now let's say for some reason you don't really want to go ahead with, you know, this embedded PostgreSQL or embedded Control-M Server, CTM900 or EM900, you just want to have databases managed externally. Okay, this is especially required when you have an external DBA team and they are the one who is responsible for managing databases. Because again, when you talk about databases, managing database itself is a very big task and complex task, because someone needs to always ensure that database is always up and running. Someone needs to ensure that database is always backed up. Someone needs to make sure that database can be recovered whenever there is a failure. Okay, so as a Control-M admin, you may not want to take care of all of these tasks. Okay, and you have a, let's say, dedicated a DBA guy in your environment. So in that case, you can go ahead with external DB. So for example, in this case, I have taken an example of Oracle DB. Let's say you want to go ahead with Oracle database, so you can do that as well. So while installing Control-M EM, you need to provide the database detail of external Oracle DB. Okay, and before you go ahead with installing Control-M EM, you need to make sure the database name already exists in the Oracle DB, and also you have an username and password to connect to that database. Again, if Oracle is installed on a different machine, in that case you need to make sure the port is opened. So Oracle by default runs on let's say 5432, pardon my handwriting. So you also need to make sure the port is open between Control-M EM to Oracle DB. Okay, so maybe whatever port this Oracle DB is running on, you need to make sure that that port is open between Control-M EM and Oracle DB. And now the same goes for Control-M Server as well. So when you want to use Oracle DB for Control-M Server, you need to make sure that you have created a database in Oracle DB. Okay, you can give CTM900 name or whatever name you want to give. Just give that name and make sure you have an username and password created on Oracle DB, and that username has sufficient privileges in order to create tables on under that database. Okay, because when this Control-M EM or Control-M servers are being installed, they are going to create their tables, views and stored procedures, okay, as part of application installation. Because Control-M EM stores lots and lots of data, and that's why it has to create lots of tables in a structured way. So you just need to make sure that you have the specified privileges. And again, before installing any of the components, just make sure that you read installation guide and you understand what you are trying to do. And for port, again, it will be the same for both. Let's say if you have Control-M server on a different server and you have Oracle on a different server, so whatever port Oracle is running on, let's say if it is running on default port of 5432, so this port should be open between Control-M server and Oracle DB. So that's it about Control-M databases. So in summary, we can say that whenever you install Control-M, you need to have minimum of two databases available. One database is going to be dedicated for Control-M EM, and other database is going to be dedicated for Control-M server. So now let's talk about Control-M databases backups. Okay, so when you are installing or going ahead with Control-M embedded PostgreSQL database, in that case Control-M provides hot backup scripts. Okay, that scripts can be used in order to take backup and also in order to restore that. And that backup store can that backup script can also be scheduled using Control-M itself. So let's say if you want to take online backup every 1 hour or every 2 hours, so you can just schedule, you can use that CTM hot backup scripts, and you can schedule that scripts using Control-M, and then it is going to just run on the scheduling frequency which you have defined. So that can be either 1 hour or 2 hours or whatever scheduling frequency you have defined, and it is going to take the backup. Now in case when you have Control-M EM and Control-M server pointing to an external database, in that case it is going to be the responsibility of Oracle DB admin to ensure that they have successfully taken the backup, or they are, you know, taking the full backup and incremental backup on the interval which is agreed as per the design of Control-M installation in your organization.